as we celebrate another one of Dr. King's birthdays, we all know there's an inauguration in front of us. This inauguration also inaugurates very trying times, very difficult times ahead of us. For people who talk like I do, for people who look like me, for Muslims in this country, for immigrants across the country, it is a very, very frightening time. And people need to understand, Donald Trump got elected by 72,000 votes in 3 states. It's hardly a mandate. And it's hardly a message for us to change course. It's a message for us to organize harder, to organize even more, and to concentrate more in our communities and rebuild this country that we all love. The progressive movement in this country has a muscle to stand up together in unity, in solidarity, and defend those people at their time of need. That's what Dr. King would say right now. Be there for the Muslims in this country. Be there for the immigrants in this country because they are scared. And the labor movement has a responsibility, not a choice, but a responsibility to bring all working people together and get them to fight for social and economic justice. But I have a stern warning, not only for the labor movement, but the progressive movement. America did not reject the work we have been doing to strengthen the labor-community relationship. America did not reject fighting for those who have been getting gunned down by the police and those who have been fighting for their lives in the Black Lives Matter movement. We have to be careful in how we move forward, because if we're not careful, if we're gonna retreat back and they say this election told us that we have to just care about white working class people, we could lose generation and generation of the emerging majority.